Using a reference image in Fresco is a fantastic way to leverage the power of your digital camera or scanner or artwork that you create in other programs. It's a fantastic technique for getting visual inspiration while you work, using another image as a compositional guide, or in a more direct way, coloring in line art for a graphic novel or a technical drawing, for example. Let's take a look at how to place images in Fresco. So down towards the bottom of the toolbar, we've got this little image icon. And with a single tap, we'll pull up a range of options to bring in images. So I can take it right from my camera, my Photos app, files stored on my device, or in this case, I'll go into my Creative Cloud files. Let's just go ahead and click on this Apple Blossoms. And then down in the lower right, I'll click Open. Now let's zoom out a little bit. And you can see here I get the option to transform my image. So I could scale it, I could rotate it. For example, let's go ahead and click Done. Notice when I import this image, I get a color palette that's automatically generated from the colors in my photo. And maybe that's as far as I'd like to go. Just grab those colors, hide this image, and completely go off in a different direction. But in this case, let's go through a couple of examples of how we might make use of an image like this in Fresco. When we first bring in our image, it's going to be housed in an image layer. And other than that initial transformation, we can't really edit it. So for example, let's go in with the fill tool and see if we could fill part of this image with black. You can see I get an error message telling me I can't do that. In order to make any additional edits, I need to convert my image layer into a pixel layer. So with that layer active, I can just tap on the layer actions in the taskbar and tap on convert to pixel layer. So this changes my layer into editable pixels, and I can manipulate them in the same exact way as any of the other layers that I might make from scratch in Fresco. So you can see here, I can grab the eraser tool, start working into that image, or I can grab any of the brush tools, for example, the pixel brush, and I can just sort of start drawing over top of this. Now, maybe this kind of freeform mixed media approach is exactly what I want. In other cases, you'll want to bring in reference art to fill in line work, for example, if you're making graphic novels or technical drawings. So let's go ahead and undo back to the point before we imported our first image. And I'm going to go ahead and grab a different one. So again, I'll click on that place image icon in the toolbar. And let's go back to our Creative Cloud and pull up a different file. So I have this one. I'll go ahead and open that. And I'll just leave the transform alone for now. So to work with this layer, we need to convert it again to a pixel layer. So I'll just tap the layer actions menu and convert to pixel. And I'd like to do one additional step here, which is to go back to layer actions and set this as a reference. So this is going to allow us to use the boundary in that line work to fill in different areas. Let's go ahead and click OK. Notice I get that little stacked icon on top of my active layer, telling me that that's a reference layer. Now let's go ahead and create a new layer on top of that, and we'll use this to fill in some of our artwork. So I'll go ahead and zoom in here, and maybe I'm interested in this character here and doing some recoloring. Let's go ahead and bring up our color picker. And so I've already got the palette of this image, and I'd like a new color. Maybe let's pick a nice red here. So maybe I'd like to go through and make sure all the hats in this image are red. I'm going to switch to the fill tool, and now I can tap on any of these areas and automatically fill them in. So the reference layer is helping us to define the boundaries of where our fill ends up. One of the coolest things about using a reference layer is when we activate our fill, we also get this color margin setting. So this lets us adjust the tolerance that Fresco is going to use when it fills in an area. You can see if I drag this all the way up to something high like 120, I'm going to get a big filled red area. If I drag this back down to something lower, I get a smaller filled area. So the lower I set my color margin, the more sensitive Fresco is going to be to variations in the drawing, and usually I'm going to get a smaller area of coverage. The higher I set my color margin, the less sensitive to variations Fresco is going to be, and I'll usually get a bigger filled area. So as I march this up, I'll get more of that hat filled in, and eventually it's going to start spilling over. Okay, that's a nice quick overview of how to use reference images in Adobe Fresco.